Hi, everyone. Welcome to the yoga show today. Today, I'm very excited to offer a power flow today, one of my favorite practices. It requires some aerobic activity, some nice deep breathing, and some very, very fluid movement. Make sure you nail down the feet today, grounding the feet, breathe deeply in and out through the nose, pull the belly in, and you will be good to go. Let's reach nice and tall, ground the feet, straighten the legs if you can, draw the belly in just enough for a slight pelvic tuck, lengthen the torso, lengthen the spine, and reach. Bring your hands back down. Hold your mountain position for a moment. This is very good for discipline, being patient in mountain pose. Turn the elbows and hands forward if you can, opening up the shoulders comfortably. And just enjoy being taller. Inhale, reach forward, lifting up the hands. And on your exhale, open the chest with the hands drawing back down to mountain pose. Inhale, lift. And exhale, open the chest and down. Inhale, lift. Warming up and opening up the shoulders a little bit, feeling some lubrication in there. Inhale, lift. Abdominals in, you're grounding your feet firmly, right? Inhale, all 10 toes, grounded, separated. One more. Inhale, lift. And exhale. Slide down your thighs about halfway here. Bending your knees with a nice tall back, take a nice arch into cow pose and exhale. On your curl, into cat, inhale, arch. Do about five of these. Nice deep inhale, draw in the navel tight. Inhale, arching away from the floor, and exhale, arching to the floor. Inhale. And exhale, trying not to use the knees at all. Keep the knees bent. Stay in your nice squat. And just open up the back here. One more. Inhale. And exhale. Slide down all the way to a gentle forward fold. Your knees can be bent here if you'd like. Just let your top of the body drop down, whether your stopping point is here or whether you drop all the way down. Let that head drop down. Let the neck relax. Shake out those knees a little bit, very softly. Feeling a nice stretch here in the hamstrings. We're just waking up the body, waking up the muscles. Just massage your knees a little here if you'd like to. Inhale, lengthen and stretch. And let's do a couple of warm-up postures. Roll up. Take your feet apart and the toes out. Bring your hands to center if you'd like, or you can bring them to your hips. Toes out about 3 to 4 feet and the heels facing in. Take a nice inhale as you lengthen your spine all the way up through the neck and the crown, and exhale for a little bit of a plié squat. Inhale, press down on your feet and lift, and exhale. Plié squat. Make sure these knees are pulling away from center. Your inside thighs drawing back. Now we're going to add to this a little. Your feet are going to be pivoting. Exhale down. Inhale, lift. Turn to your left. Take a nice gentle lunge, bringing the knee down. And inhale, lift. Another plié squat. Get ready to turn to your right. Turning the toes to the right, bringing that left knee down. And lift. Let's keep going. Exhale, inhale, tall. Exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. This is actually kind of fun. Exhale, inhale, exhale. Remember, you really need to ground the feet firmly. Exhale, inhale, toes out. Now toes facing right. Toes out. Inhale up, toes facing left, torso facing left, up. One more set. And down. If you don't ground the feet firmly, you lose a little bit of balance here. Last one. Exhale down. and turn right and lunge. Come back to center, bring the feet together, take a nice inhale and lift. Bring your hands to center, take the feet out one more time. On your exhale, begin another plié squat here. Now, if this is your maximum today, not 100%, but maybe 70 or 80%, go ahead and stop and hold here. Continue breathing with your torso as high as possible, chest and heart lifted. If you can get down a little further, slide the arms inside the legs. Stay in contact here with the legs, opening up the thighs, and exhale as the hips come downward toward the ground. The feet need to stay flat here, knees facing the toes, knees in that same tracking direction as the toes. Pull the abdominals in tight, bring your hands to center, and draw the thighs outward and away from center using a little pressure here. Push your palms together, nice stretch in the wrists here, everything's working, legs are stretching, buttocks, low back. Couple more breaths here. Draw the abs in a little bit tighter. This is good for your abdominals, good for your core. Press on the feet as you inhale, slowly come up. That's not too easy, is it? Bring it to the front of your mat. Take a nice lift up, reaching tall. And exhale, take a forward bend right here. Inhale, lift. Stretch, bracing with the fingers. Exhale, bring it down. Take that left leg backward to a nice high lunge, heart forward. Exhale, take it back to downward facing dog. Hold your downward facing dog two or three breaths here. A good amount of pressure with the hands, pressing the mat forward and away from you, or your carpet forward and away from you. Inhale, rock that body forward. Nice and plank, rock hard. Exhale, keep the elbows into the body. Inhale, lift to cobra if you'd like, or high cobra, or upward facing dog. Tuck the toes. Exhale, downward facing dog. And walk your feet forward. Releasing on your exhale to forward bend. Inhale, lengthen and stretch. And exhale, release. Let's sweep all the way up, reaching tall, and exhale. Another forward fold. Release down. Stretch and lengthen. Flat back, abdominals in. Release back down. Take the front leg back, your right leg, I believe. Send it backward into a nice high lunge. Lift that torso, and exhale, press back, downward dog. Take an inhale, rock the body forward, and exhale to your chaturanga. Inhale, lift to whatever you'd like. Exhale, send it back. Abdominals in. Ah, walk or jump all the way forward, all the way to your fingers. Take as many steps as you need to. Release and forward fold. Stretch, lengthen the spine. Release and sweep all the way up. Bring your hands to center. All right. Let's take one more gentle warm-up for the legs. Inhale and lift. Exhale, bring it down. Step the first leg back again, your left leg into high lunge. Send it back to plank pose. Step that same leg forward. High lunge. Ah, exhale. Back to plank pose. First leg, again, forward. And back. Second leg, forward. This is not easy. And back to plank pose. First leg, forward. And back to plank pose. I'm trying not to lift my hips very much. I'm not coming backward to downward dog to do this. That's what makes it a little challenging. Exhale, lunge forward. High lunge, one more. Take it back to plank pose. Ah, inhale, prepare now. Exhale, First leg forward. See, it gets a little bit tiring. One more to go. Send it back. And exhale. Right leg forward. Whew! That's tough from plank pose. Push off that back foot. Inhale, grounding both feet for your forward bend. Relax back down. Oh, that feels better. Release that spine. Shake out those legs. Inhale, lengthen and stretch. Release down. Sweep all the way up. And bring your hands to your hips. Okay, we're going to do a series of warrior postures and go into triangle right here in our flow. Bring your hands to your hips. Inhale. Send this front leg, your right leg, backward. Angling that front foot, preparing for warrior one. Drawing the front knee forward, the back foot stays angled and grounded. Attempting to bring that front knee right over the heel, pressing firm with both feet. Feel your area around the abdominals and the hips really activated. Arms coming up. Breathe here in warrior one. Open up here to warrior two. Adjust that back foot a little bit. The back foot now is faced about 90 degrees. Still lunging with this left leg. Pulling the hands far apart. Pulling the arms away from the chest. Abdominals in. Torso facing front. Warrior two. Reaching away from the heart. Looking over these front fingers. Release that right hand, lift that left arm up to the sky, press firmly on the feet, and reach up into your exalted warrior or reverse warrior. You can look up to your hand, you can look forward, or you can look down to the back foot, whatever works for you. Our left chest, open up to the sky. On your inhale, come back to warrior two. Straightening that front leg. Torso straight ahead, reach to the left. Reaching out, not moving those hips. Elongating that spine, stretch. Pushing down with the feet and open into your triangle pose. Abdominals in. Now remember, you may be up here, bracing slightly inside the leg. We're not leaning on the leg at all. Or some people can get down here, long as that body is in a nice, straight square line. Push with both feet back into warrior two. And rotate on that back foot. Come forward. Inhale. Whoops. Ah, and release. Bring it all the way up. Let's take a short vinyasa here. Exhale. Forward bend. Strengthen. Lift, stretch, release back down. Send yourself back to plank pose, bending the knees. Exhale, bringing that chest down, chaturanga. Inhale, bringing it up, upward facing dog. Send it on back, downward facing dog. Ooh, rest your back for a moment. Feels wonderful. Walk your feet forward, look right where you're walking, right in between the thumbs. Release and fold over on your exhale. Inhale, stretch out and lengthen. And let's release again. Sweeping up when you're ready, reaching tall. Bring your hands to your hips. And so that I won't face backwards away from you, I'm going to come to this side of the mat. Step back now with the opposite foot in a gentle lunge, opening up for warrior one. The back foot is angled, the hips as square as possible, facing forward. Lunging with that front knee, abdominals in. Take a nice inhale and lift gracefully, pressing on the feet, both feet drawing that back hip of the bent knee slightly backward. Notice how it really activates the entire core area. just what you want. Two more breaths. This is Warrior One. Opening up to Warrior Two. Adjusting that foot a little bit, taking that lunge, hands reaching apart. Reach away from the heart, looking over these fingers. Oh, keep the power in the arms now. Make sure the arms are flexing. One more breath here. Oh, this feels great. Release this back hand toward the thigh. Flip that front hand. Lift into your reverse warrior. The outer right chest lifting up. You can look up at that right hand if you'd like, or you can look down at the foot or look straight ahead if your neck doesn't allow for that. Pressing strong in the feet, abdominals still in. Come back to Warrior Two. Straightening the right leg. Standing nice and tall, still pressing on the feet. Reach, abdominals in, reach to your right. Arms are straight, legs are straight, pressing on the feet. Lifting up with this left arm, gently bracing with the right. You can look down at the front foot, you can look forward, or you can look up in triangle, whatever your balance or body are up for today. Keeping the abdominals in. Lift back up, bending that front knee for Warrior Two again. Oh, that feels great. Bring your hands up. Rotate and push forward. Ah, inhale, lift. Take your fold here. Exhale, bring it down. Rest your spine. Enjoy this slight rest. Feel the back opening up. Draw the belly in, which pushes the tailbone, your sacrum, down toward the floor, elongating the low spine. Inhale and lengthen. Exhale, release back down and send yourself back to plank pose. Exhale, coming down to chaturanga. Elbows into the body. Inhale, lifting to upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. We continually move in flow. We do hold our postures, of course. We're continually moving from posture to posture. Walk forward or jump, looking right in between your hands. That's where your feet are going. Release and relax. Ah, fold over. And inhale, lengthen and stretch. Ah, that felt wonderful, didn't it? Sweep, a big sweep. Open the chest here. Lifting tall. And exhale, bring your hands to prayer. Take a gentle and soft rest. Rest your breath for a moment. Listen to your breath. You can feel your heart. We're going to step back to the front of the mat. Raise nice and tall. Exhale into your fold. Lengthen and stretch on your inhale. Exhale, release it. Now soften your knees. Go back into plank pose. What we're going to do is a three-legged plank. Not to be confused with three-legged dog. Our arm is actually going to pick up, not one of our feet. So here we want to gather the balance first, separate the feet, make sure they're hips width or shoulder width apart if you're just beginning. Pull the abs in very tight. First see how you balance. See if you can get going on the tripod and reach forward. Whew. This is tough. Pressing away from the ground. Hand back down. Whew. Take a breath. Strong legs, pulling the abs tight, and reach. Make sure we're not twisting, by the way, this is not a twist. Reach forward, hips are square, and back down, abs very tight. Reach, and down, and reach. and down. One more set. Straight legs, abs tight. Reach and down. Isn't this fantastic? Reach and down. Lower the knees here. Oh, I bet you were waiting for that. I was. Relax in child's pose, all right? Relax the neck, the shoulders. Oh. Roll up. You're sitting on your heels here. I'll turn slightly forward for you at an angle. I'm going to go into a camel pose. If you're not very limber, you can tuck your toes back here because we're going to take our back bend and reach for the feet. So your toes can be tucked or the tops of the feet flat, okay? Tucking the toes. Lift up to center, pulling in the abdominals. Now your abdominals are very, very important here. You want them very, very tight. Slight pelvic tuck, pressing down in the toes. Inhale and lift your heart forward, pressing on the toes, pulling your abs in, reach for the backs of your feet. Continue pulling your quads and your pelvis forward. Let your head drop if that's comfortable. And breathe here. You're opening up the chest, the heart, the full front of the body. Breathe. Bring your chin to your heart. Release your hands and very slowly sit backward to your heels again. Relax your feet. Come back into child's pose. That's a very rejuvenating stretch, a very rejuvenating asana, camel pose. If you'd like to, press down on the feet. Lift the hips up, tuck your head and chin, round your spine, and come into rabbit pose. And again, if you can, reach for your feet and pull away. Pull the chest away from your thighs, drawing the navel upward. Release the hips back down. All right, let's come into the upper back here. I'm breaking quite a sweat here. Hope I don't slip on my mat. I may have to adjust myself. Bring your feet in front. Feet all the way out, legs slightly bent, hands shoulder width apart behind the body, behind the hips, and just outside. You'll find that that's shoulder width apart. Take an inhale, pressing firmly on the hands. Roll your toes down to the ground and lift, straighten the arms and lift the hips upward, drawing your shoulder blades together behind you. Shoulder blades together. This is a upward plank or reverse plank. Pull those toes down to flatten the feet. You're lifting the hips high. Slowly release the hips down. Release your arms. Take a nice breath in. Lengthen the spine and roll back and curl your spine for a nice counter stretch. We're going to do this two more times. Let's rock forward. Bend the legs slightly, feet as flat as you can. Now, if you can't start out with your feet flat, that's okay. You can pull the toes down as you're coming into your upward plank. Secure the hands, fingers face forward, nice and spread, facing forward toward the toes. Inhale, And pull the elbows together, pull the shoulder blades together, lifting the hips up. Try to straighten those arms. Don't lock out the elbows, but straighten the arms. Pull the toes down, a lot to remember here, and let your head drop comfortably. Keep lifting those hips high, opening the front of the body. My mat is slipping a little bit. Just try to ignore that, because you're probably busy doing this posture yourself. Lower down, pull your chin to your heart. Inhale, lift and lengthen, and exhale, roll back, bringing your knees to your heart. One more, rolling up. I'll turn just a little bit here for you to get off my mat, actually. Hands behind, fingers facing forward, nice and spread and firm. Lock down those heels, pull the abs in tight. Inhale, pull those toes down, pointing the toes all the way, lift up. Lift the hips up, pull the toes down to the floor, drop your head back, pull your shoulders away from your ears, and the shoulder blades together at center behind you. One more breath, lift a half an inch higher. Lower your hips, draw your chin to your heart. Release your knees, inhale, lift, long spine, and exhale, roll back. So your counter stretches, counter postures are very important in yoga. Yoga is about balance. Let's roll up and take some stretches. Well, I guess we're out of time, so let's cross our legs in front. Inhale, lengthen here. Exhale, take the opposite hand to each knee. And bring the chest forward on your exhale. Your back is opening up here, your upper back, your lower back. You can really feel it. It's heavenly. Roll up gently. Inhale, raise the arms tall. Keep stretching. All right, keep stretching and take a nice rest. Take a savasana for at least 5 minutes. Thank you for joining me today on The Yoga Show. I will see you next time. Stay strong. Namaste.